dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters, scattered throughout the world, to come together to watch and pray. If we keep memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we should have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify each new fire, and grant, we pray, by these Paschal celebrations, we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires, that with eyes may be pure, we may attain festivities of unending strength. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha, the Omega, all time belongs to him, and all the ages, to him be glory and power through every age forever. Amen. By his holy. By his holy and glorious wounds. May Christ our Lord guard us and protect us.
Rejoice, O shining earth, in glorious falling warm, and praise the light and love the first creation's dawn. Redeemed and free in Christ we rise, and darkness dies eternally. Rejoice, O Mother Church, on you the Saviour shines. Then let the vaults resound with peace and joy divine. His truth proclaim and loud and long, in glorious song exalt his name. The people who have walked in terror through the night, from shades of death released, have seen a glorious light. God's word is sure and he will bless with righteousness the humble poor. O God of hope and love, who lit the desert way and led from slavery's night to liberation's day, still go before till we rejoice with heart and voice on Canaan's shore. We light these gentle flames to be our pledge and sign. We share the risen life of Christ, the light divine. Throughout the earth, oppression's night shall flee the light of human worth. Arise, O morning star, O sun who never sets, and bring these humble flames to greater glory yet. Let all adoring glorious strains the Christ who reigns forevermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who lives and reigns forevermore, world without end. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God, in times past, saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
God saw that it was good. God said, That they are produce vegetation, seed bearing plants, and fruit trees bearing fruit with their seed inside on the earth. And so it was. The earth produced vegetation, plants bearing seed in their several kinds, and trees bearing fruit with their seeds inside in their several kinds. God saw that it was good. Evening came and morning came, the third day. God said, let there be lights in the vault of heaven to divide day from night, and let them indicate festivals, days and years. Let there be lights in the vault of heaven to shine on the earth. And so it was. God made the two great lights, the greater light to govern the day, the smaller light to govern the night and the stars. God set in the vault of heaven to shine on the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to divide light from darkness. God saw that it was good. Evening came and morning came, the fourth day. God said, let the waters teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the air within the vaults of heaven. And so it was. God created great sea serpents, and every kind of living creature with which the waters teem, and every kind of winged creature. God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful, multiply, and fill the waters of the seas, and let the birds multiply upon the earth. Evening came, and morning came, the fifth day. God said, let the earth produce every kind of living creature, cattle, reptiles, and every kind of wild beast. And so it was. God made every kind of wild beast, every kind of cattle, and every kind of land reptile. God saw that it was good. God said, let us make man in our own image, in the likeness of ourselves, and let them be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, the cattle, all the wild beasts, and all the reptiles that crawl upon the earth. God created man in the image of himself. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying to them, be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth and conquer it. Be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, and all living animals on the earth. God said, see, I give you all the seed-bearing plants that are upon the whole earth, and all the trees with seed-bearing fruit. This shall be your food. To all wild beasts, all birds of heaven, and all living reptiles on the earth, I give all the foliage of plants for food. And so it was. God saw all he had made, and indeed, it was very good. Evening came, and morning came, the sixth day. Thus heaven and earth were completed with all their array. On the seventh day, God completed the work he had been doing. He rested on the seventh day after all the work that he had been doing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
sons of Israel to walk through the sea on dry ground. I, for my part, will make the heart of the Egyptians so stubborn that they will follow them. So shall I win myself glory at the expense of Pharaoh, of all his army, his chariots, his horsemen. And when I have won glory for myself at the expense of Pharaoh and his chariots and his army, the Egyptians will learn that I am the Lord. Then the angel of the Lord, who marched at the front of the army of Israel, changed station and moved to their rear. The pillar of cloud changed station from the front to the rear of them and remained there. It came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. The cloud was dark, and the night passed without the armies drawing any closer the whole night long. Moses stretched out his arm over the sea. The Lord drove back the sea with a strong in-easterly wind all night, and he made dry land of the sea. The waters parted, and the sons of Israel went on dry ground right into the sea, walls of water to right and to left of them. The Egyptians, in this case, after them they went right into the sea, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. In the morning watch, the Lord looked down on the army of the Egyptians from the pillar of fire and cloud, and threw the army into confusion. He so clogged their chariot wheels that they could scarcely make headway. "Let us flee from the Israelites," the Egyptians cried. "The Lord is fighting for them against the Egyptians." "Stretch out your hand over the sea," the Lord said to Moses, "that the waters may flow back on the Egyptians and their chariots and their horsemen." Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and as day broke, the sea returned to its bed. The fleeing Egyptians marched right into it, and the Lord overthrew the Egyptians in the very middle of the sea. The returning waters overwhelmed the chariots and the horsemen of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them was left. But the sons of Israel had marched through the sea on dry ground, walls of water to right and to left of them. That day, the Lord rescued Israel from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the shore. Israel witnessed the great act that the Lord had performed against the Egyptians, and the people venerated the Lord. They put their faith in the Lord and in Moses, his servant. It was then that Moses and the sons of Israel sang this song in honor of the Lord.
Glory as the sky on. Water, joy, A reading from the prophet Baruch. Listen, Israel, to commands that bring life. Hear and live what knowledge means. Why, Israel, why are you in the country of your enemy? Grow your own and over an alien land, sharing defilement with death. Reckon with those who go to shore, because you have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. Had you walked in the way of God, you would have lived in peace forever. Living with knowledge is, with strength, with understanding, and so familiar with the length of days, where life is, with the light of the eyes, and with peace. But who has found out the way of shearers, who has entered through treasures? But the one who knows all, he is grasping with his own intellect. He has sent the earth through forever and filled it with four-footed beasts. He sends the light with joy. He recalls it and trembling it obeys. The stars shine joyfully at their set times. When he calls them, they answer, "You do not." We gladly shine for their creator. It is He who is our God. No other can compare with Him. He has grasped the whole way of knowledge and confined it to His servant Jacob, to Israel, His well-beloved. So causing Him to appear on earth and move among men. This is the book of the commandments of God. The law that stands forever. Those who keep their lives, those who deserve to die. Turn back, Jacob. Caesar in the radiance. Make your way to light. Do not yield your glory to another, your privilege to a people, not your own. Israel, blessed are we what pleases God. Has been revealed to us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God who made this most sacred night, radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first letter, from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized in his death. In other words, when we were baptized, we went into the tomb with him and joined him in death. So that as Christ was raised from the dead by the Father's glory, we too might live a new life. If in union with Christ we have imitated his death, we shall also imitate him in his resurrection. We must realize that our former selves have been crucified with him to destroy this sinful body and to free us from the slavery of sin. When a man dies, of course, he has finished with sin. But we believe that having died with Christ, we shall return to life with him. As we know, having been raised from the dead, will never die again. Death has no power over him anymore. When he died, he died once for all to sin. So his life now is life with God. And in that way, you too must consider yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord,
Cain rolled away the stone and sat on it. His face was shining like lightning, and his robe white as snow. The guards were so shaken, so frightened of him, that they were like dead men. But the angel spoke, and he said to the women, "There is no need for you to be afraid. I know who you are looking for. Jesus, who was crucified, he is not here, but he has risen, as he said he would. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has risen from the dead, and now he is going before you to Galilee. It is there you will see him. Now I have told you, filled with awe and great joy, the women came quickly away from the tomb and ran to tell the disciples. And there coming to meet them was Jesus. Greetings, he said. And the women came up to him, falling down before him, clasped his feet. Then Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers, they must leave for Galilee. They will see me there. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And then halfway, and he just loved it, his face would light up. with the joy of ringing the bell. Unfortunately, the bell became unclipped and threw half the young children. We nearly took somebody's head off. The Easter Vigil is a memorable night because it renews us in faith and in spirit. It calls us to remember that Jesus rose from the dead for each and every one of us. We've been through a beautiful journey this Holy Week with our celebration of the Lord's Supper, where we remember Jesus' great gift of the Eucharist, that we are nourished daily, if we wish, by a great gift of his body and blood. Yesterday we had the solemn celebration of the Passion, when we quietly reflected on the suffering of Christ. Tonight, we have this glorious service of light, the Easter Vigil, and the morning veil of Lent, and the colour purple is gone, replaced by the brightness of flowers, of music, and song, and the glorious Alleluia. And as we gather together this night, we also with joy draw waters from the wells of salvation. Tonight with us we have two people who will be baptized. We have four people who will be received and confirmed into the Catholic Church. And we will now go into that part of our beautiful celebration of the Easter Vigil. Dear friends, let us pray for Almighty God for Ye and Hong. Who are asking to be baptized. God has called them and brought them to this moment. May He grant them light and strength to follow Christ with a resolute heart and to profess the faith of the Church. May He give them the new life of the Holy Spirit, who we will pour down on the waters and ponds. Let us also ask for the prayers of the saints who have gone before us in faith. I also call those who are to be received into the Church. Michael, come with your sponsor. Shelley, come with your sponsor also. Toby and Thomas. Brothers and sisters, we now walk together in faith, singing to the saints that they will come down upon us and lead us always in hope. So as we process around the church, please pray for our candidates. God may bless the people at this time. Baptism, the usual gift of water, which you have made a rich symbol of grace, you give us to this sacrament. The very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed from the waters, making them the wellsprings of holiness. The waters of the great flood, you make the sign of the waters of baptism, to make an end of sin and the beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery, to be the image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism, in the waters of the Jordan. In the waters of the Jordan, your son was baptized by John, and anointed with the Spirit. You willed that the blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. And after his resurrection, he told his disciples, go, baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit, give to this water the grace of your Son, so that in the sacrament of baptism, all those who have created in your likeness may be cleansed from sin and rise to a new birth of innocence by water and the Holy Spirit. You have called your children to this cleansing water and new birth, that by sharing the faith of your church, they may have eternal life. Bless this water which they are to be baptized. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord. Amen. So candidates for baptism, candidates for reception into the church and confirmation, I now ask you to profess your faith in Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, you have asked to be baptized and received into the Catholic Church. Through this sacrament, through these sacraments, you are called to a life of holiness and love. I now ask you to turn away from sin and believe in the good news. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the power of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? We announce those who are to be confirmed. Nothing important, just the oil. And now I want on women. The order of Catholic kings, preparing them for the faith that you will receive through baptism. We anoint you with this oil. May you be free from original sin. May you be always as a child of God. May you cast light, darkness away, and put off the shadow of light. Through Christ our Lord. I anoint you with this oil. May you cast on away the slavery of sin. Walk always in God's kingdom of light. So I ask the candidates who are to be baptized, is it your will that you should be baptized in the Catholic faith? Thank you. Christ's celebration. Let I present you with white garments, the sign of the new life of baptism that you have assumed this night. Wear this garment this night proudly to show you have become a new creation in Christ. Mike, Thomas, Toby and Shelley, of your own free will you have asked to be received into full communion in the Catholic Church. You have made your decisions after careful thought under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. In the presence of this community, I now invite you to be open to the faith of the Catholic Church. You have journeyed together with our ABC course. You have learnt about the Catholic faith, and this night you will be one with us for the first time at the Eucharistic table of the Lord Jesus, the sign of the Church is used. I ask your sponsors to place their right hand on your shoulder. Michael, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has brought you and led you to this moment, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that we will profess with you in the presence of this family. Thomas, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that we have professed in the presence of this family. Toby, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here this night, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that we will profess with you in the presence of this family. Shelley, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit you may have full communion with us in the faith that we will confess in the presence of his Father. Of your own free will, you have asked to receive the sacraments of confirmation. You have made your decision after careful thought, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. In doing so, you are called to grow deeper in faith and stronger in your kindness to others. We now pray for you that you will always be a light to others. O powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, You have freed your sons and daughters from sin and has given them new birth and new life. Send your Holy Spirit to be with them as their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
With the laying on of hands upon your heads, we pray that God's Spirit will come down upon you all. Michael, be anointed with the oil of chrism. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you now live always as a child of light. Thomas, be anointed with the oil of chrism. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, live always now as a child of God. Toby, be anointed with the oil of chrism. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, you have now walked always as a child of his light. Shelley, be anointed with the oil of chrism. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, live always as a child of light. Pauline, be anointed with holy chrism. Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king. Live always as a child of God. Be anointed with the oil of chrism. Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king. Live always as a child of God's love. You now to take a light from the paschal candle. Careful not to tip the candle, Jeffrey, the wax goes everywhere.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. You children of God, through water and the Holy Spirit, now being received into the Catholic Church, soon to receive Holy Communion for the first time, for four, for six, five of you, I now invite you to go and spread the light of Christ with the congregation you have gathered. And we stand to be prepared to renew our own promises above. Dear friends in Christ, through the Paschal Mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may rise with him to new life. Now that we have completed our Lenten observance, let us renew the promises we made in baptism, when we rejected Satan and his words. We promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. So I ask you all, do you reject Satan?
I do.
And all his words.
I do.
And all his empty promises.
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith, the faith of the Church, and we are always proud to profess it through Christ Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Oh,
We now remain standing as we turn to the Lord with our giving. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the risen Lord may illuminate the minds of government leaders to enable them to protect the right and the life of every human being.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have been baptized and received into the church this night, that they may grow in holiness.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the light of the risen Christ may shine upon the poor, the afflicted, the hungry, the homeless, and the unborn.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that Christ, who conquered death, may welcome them to the eternal feast of life and light.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
With Mary, we stand at the empty tomb, in the hope of the risen Lord. Let us now ask now for her intercession, as we say.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In our hearts.
Lord, you have already granted us all we can ask for in the resurrection of Christ. As you answer our prayers, make us ever more faithful to him, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that thy sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. Through Christ, Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night, above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lord, I pray that you
introduce the receiving of the chalice of the blessed blood of our holy blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you wish to receive from the chalice, please do. If you don't wish to receive from the chalice, remember that you still receive the fullness of Christ in receiving the house. I will also give communion to those who have been baptized and received into the church first of all, and then once that is done, the others will come, the rest of you may come and receive.
Lord of Christ,
the Son of God.
of Christ. The body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and on his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those whose feasts are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
Once again, just my best wishes and congratulations to those who were baptized in the church tonight and those who were received in the church. I think we can give them all another big round of applause. For those of you who wish to, there are some refreshments in the parish centre. Well, I know there's wine. I'm not too sure about bring and share. Have you brought something to bring and share? All right, good. I never want you down to have a look. So you're all very welcome to go down to the parish centre for light refreshments or heavy refreshments. I don't know what you brought. And I also wish each and every one of you a very happy, blessed, and holy Christmas. I know that Easter. Or maybe Lent. Very happy, holy, and blessed Easter. And if you are going away, have a lovely time. If you are receiving guests, have a lovely time as well. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Recording.